Oh, I know why you're here. Did you just install an app that's asking, hey, enable this ADB permission, or transferring files, or probably just changing resolutions? Well, you got the right guy.
Bruh.
So what I'm gonna do today is show you how to download, install and set up ADB on your phone and on your desktop PC or laptop. So let's go deeper. All right, so what you need for this is your trusty PC or laptop and the USB cable that you'll be connecting your phone to your laptop. Ouch. And of course your phone. So here we are in the desktop. What we need first is to download and install platform tools. The link is in the description, of course. Now this is the page that you will open. You'll go to download for Windows, Mac or Linux, whatever you're using. In this case, I'm using Windows 10. I agree, download and choose a location. For you skeptics out there, it's scanning for viruses, so you'd know that it's not virus. Here it is. You just need to right-click it and extract all. Extract to this. Just click extract and wait.
I apologize, but my potato quality laptop is doing what potatoes do.
All right, it's done. What you need to do is go inside the folder, platform tools. Now this is the folder we need. Cut. Go to this PC and go to your C directory, local disk it's probably named on your PC, and here you are. What you need to do is create a new folder named Android. Now, paste. Now what this the next step is, go inside the platform tools and copy the directory here. Click here, copy, and search for this PC, right click, properties, go to the bottom, advanced system settings, then environmental variables. And go to path, double click it, this one, path. Click new, and then paste what you copied the directory here. This is a way to make it easier to use it later on command prompt. I will show you now. Now you have successfully installed ADB. We close this, and go back to our phone.
So, in order to activate developer options and USB debugging, you do these steps. First of all, go to settings. Then at the end, you go to about phone, software information, and build number. You have to tap it repeatedly. And it will ask about your PIN. After inserting your PIN, it will say that developer options are on. As you see, they show that at the end of the settings. Now, what you need to do is scroll down and you have USB debugging. Activate that. Click OK. And that's all, it's on. Let's go.
Now what you need to do is connect your phone to your PC. After connecting, now we go back and open command prompt. Search at start, command prompt. PowerShell, it's the same thing. In my case, I will use terminal. Terminal, right click and run as administrator. Yes. Now, what you need to do here, we have already installed ADB. After connecting the device, you have to check if the device is recognized. So we write ADB devices and it will check for the devices connected. You see, in the phone it will show this and you click allow. Now ADB devices again and it will say that it's connected. Now what you need to do is then, whatever app you're using, you write ADB shell vm grand, and you click the command that is given at the app. So that's all.
Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like and comment anything below. Comment any questions too. Subscribe for more to come. Bye!